안녕하세요. 메이크업 아티스트 정세물입니다. 지난 시간에 했던 동근 얼굴형을 위한 컨투어 메이크업에 이어 오늘은 각진 얼굴형을 위한 페이스 컨투어에 관해서 알려드릴게요. 그럼 시작해볼까요?
페이스 컨투어 for a square shaped face.
안녕하세요. 메이크업 아티스트 손주입니다. 얼굴 형태 중 각진형은 지적으로 보이기도 하지만 자칫 강해 보이기도 하는데요. 각진 형태를 보완하여 컨투어링하는 방법을 보여드릴게요.
Let me start with the foundation on. The blush should be applied to the point where the V-zone connects to the tip of the nose. For a square-shaped face, you should contour the outer face diagonally. When choosing a blush color, you just need to choose the one that looks good on the model and that matches the makeup concept. This video will focus on application method. Let me mix natural coral and pink together. Pick up the blush with a brush. To make long-lasting makeup, I'll mix it with pearl powder. I'm using the wet and dry theory of key 7. Apply the blush to the point where the V-zone connects to the tip of the nose. Work in a circular motion and move upward diagonally. Blend well to remove any harsh and obvious lines, relaxing your hand. Do the same for the other side. Let's have a look at the parts we should apply contour shades to. Apart from those cases where you don't contour a square-shaped face to make it look attractive, you should apply the shades to contour the jawline and both sides of the forehead for a sharper and gentle look of face. Choose a beige-brown color that's one or two shades darker than the skin color. You should start contouring the face just like how you normally do. Start at the sideburns and work in a fan shape. As you get closer to the inner part of the face, there should be less shade applied, making a gradient look. Blend it well with the blush. Try contouring the jawline a bit darker. Do the same for the other side. Don't forget to shade the ear flap. Most people forget to shade the ear flap, but it won't look natural. Apply the darker shade to the jawline. Next, let me apply some highlighter. In order not to make the square face look apparent, you should highlight the T-zone, C-zone, philtrum, and chin to make the face look three-dimensional. The highlighter should be applied to the center of the face so that the outer part doesn't stand out. Dip a soft, thick brush with a dense flattened head into the highlighter. Apply it to the C-zone and around the eyes. Use the tip of the brush to apply it to the right part. Sweep the T-zone. Try to apply it to the area above the brow bone and nose bridge. Let me contour the hairline. Choose a brown shade that matches the hair color. Hold a round, flat, and short brush vertically and shade in the hair. Hold the brush flat when shading between the hair. Since she has a square-shaped forehead, it's important to contour both of the edges of the forehead. Use a firm, short brush to contour the hairline. Use a cotton swab to get rid of clumps. It's also good to use a sponge. Do the same for the other side. Let me finish off by setting the skin with powder. Pick up the powder and remove excess on a palette. Apply it to the T-zone where oil tends to accumulate the most and the cheeks that tend to have large pores. Gently dab the powder and try not to wipe off the foundation. And now, we're done.
This 강의는 어떠셨나요? 지난 몇 주에 걸쳐 다양한 얼굴형에 어울리는 컨투어 메이크업을 소개시켜 드렸는데요. 도움이 되셨으면 좋겠습니다. 영상을 보시고 궁금한 점 혹은 이해 안 되는 점 있으시면 댓글 남겨주세요. 그럼 최대한 참고해서 설명드리도록 노력하겠습니다. 그럼
좋아요와 구독, 댓글까지
부탁드려요. 영상에서 만나요. 안녕.